Hey guys, what's up? Today I have a top 10 horror on Netflix streaming video. This is for US streaming only, and it was really hard to narrow this down. I think I had about 30 movies that I really liked, and this is horror only. So I narrowed it down to 10, and these aren't in any particular order. The first one I want to talk about is Raw. It's a coming-of-age story of a young girl who's going to veterinarian school, and she's a vegetarian, and while in school, she kind of finds out that she has other cravings. So it's a cannibal coming of age story, and what really makes this movie amazing is the actress in it. I don't want to butcher her name, but it's Garance Marillier, I think, and she really consumed her character. Next up is Hush, and I think this is the most like watchable for everyone kind of movie on my list. It is a home invasion thriller horror, and what makes it interesting the most home invasions is the protagonist. Because she's deaf, the killer kind of taunts her. I like that they didn't give any backstory to the killer, and it's directed by Mike Flanagan, and I think he really excels in contained horror movies. They added this, I think, recently, The Craft, Light as a Feather, Stiff as a Board. Light as a Feather, Stiff as a Board. I love this movie. It's a 90s teen witch movie, and it's fun. It stars Robin Tooney, Neve Campbell, and Fairuza Balk plays the bitch witch, and she killed it in her performance. It's like the Clueless of teen witch movies. I love it. Next is The Eyes of My Mother, written and directed by Nicholas Pesce, who's also directing the next Grudge movie, which isn't a remake. I think it's gonna be like a sequel. I don't know if they've done three or four. Anyways, that's gonna come out in 2019. It's in black and white. It's just so weird. I don't know how to explain it. This girl is raised on a farm with her parents, and then when she was young, her mother gets murdered, and her father, instead of... Do you hear my dog snoring? And her father, instead of killing that murderer or putting him in jail, he locks him up in the barn, and she kind of keeps him as a pet. And she's kind of a Norman Bates. It's a movie about loneliness and what some people do when they're lonely. Next is The Collection. I recently saw this. I saw The Collector a while ago and I liked it, but I feel like the sequel is superior to The Collector. It stars the guy with the puppy dog face. Hold on, let me see his name. Josh Stewart. He's in this one too, because at the end of The Collector, he was put in the suitcase because The Collector takes one victim from every killing spree. In the beginning of this movie, someone lets him out of the box, and he's really the hero in this movie. You do get a Saw vibe to it. I think some of the writers of Saw had something to do with this. I like that you never see the killer's face at all. You do see him like in blurs or the back of his head, but I like how they never show his face. Next is 30 Days of Night. This is on my like top 5 vampire movies ever list. And another one is The Lost Boys, but that's not on Netflix. That's the shirt I'm wearing right now. 30 Days of Night is like the vampire movie that doesn't glamorize vampires. It stars Josh Hartnett. The story is really cool. It's based on a graphic novel. So these killer vampires invade this town in Alaska. I think it's Barrow, Alaska, where there's 30 days of no sun, and they viciously attack this town. And it's just a really well done vampire movie. Next on my list is Clown. It's produced by Eli Roth, and it's directed by John Watts, who went on to do Spider-Man Homecoming. And it's not like one of those goofy clown movies. The father is a realtor who is on his way to his son's birthday party, and the clown canceled. He finds his clown suit in the house that he's showing, and he can't take it off, and then he kind of becomes the demon. It's actually not a clown, it's demon skin. I really like the premise of the story. It is a unique clown movie. Up next is The Babadook, and what makes this movie awesome is Essie Davis's performance. Like, the mother in it is really convincing as this distressed, heartbroken mom who is kind of sick of her child, and yeah, her performance was great. So it's about this mother and son. The father actually died in a car accident on the way to the hospital, so she kind of never forgives the son for that. She reads him this book called The Babadook, and the illustrations in it are really cool. The Babadook character in it comes to life. This is one of those movies like The Monster where the book is a metaphor for something else. It's really well done. Definitely check it out. Next movie is The Devil's Candy. Sean Byrne directed it. He also directed The Loved Ones, and his style is just very cool. It stars Ethan Embry, and he looks like Jesus in this movie. Him and his family family purchased this house. Actually, there was a murder in the house. That's why it was so cheap. And he's a painter, and he starts to hear voices, and then he paints what he hears. And there's a serial killer who is killing children because he hears the devil. And he kills the children for the devil, so the devil's candy is like children's souls. I think it's really well done. If you like rock music, check it out. And my last one is Darling. And again, these are in no particular order. I put this on my list because it is very artsy. This is directed by Mickey Keating, and you can tell that he loves Hitchcock and he loves Polanski. It's shot in black and white, and it's about a girl who is a caretaker for this mansion. And throughout her stay there, she kind of goes crazy. Or I think she is already crazy, so it makes it worse. And if you like artsy horror, it's a good one. And all these are available on Netflix streaming US right now. I have 5 honorable mentions. I won't talk about these too much. I'll just mention them in case you want other movies to check out. The first one is Starry Eyes. Next is Before I Wake, another Mike Flanagan movie. Would You Rather, Teeth, and Odd Thomas. I'll write all of these in my description box so you can check them out. These are just my opinion of what I like, but I know there's like a ton of good horror movies on Netflix right now. So let me know what your favorites are. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.